Thank you very much, all of you here in this wonderful conclave and all of you tuning in. I want to thank you for listening to your hearts. Wow, are we ever blessed to be able to gather together during this cosmic moment in the evolution of this planet. This is such an incredibly powerful time. We're going to talk about some of the specifics because the beings of light, literally our sisters and brothers in the heavenly realms who have been working with us for eons of time, want us to consciously know on a tangible level the magnitude of what is occurring this very special and important time frame of 12-12-12, then building up to the activities of light that will take place on December 21st and 22nd. This is something that each and every one of us has been preparing for literally hundreds of lifetimes. No one is here on this planet by mistake. We each have a unique golden thread of light that we are weaving into this magnificent unfolding divine plan. And when I talk about we through this talk, I'm talking about every man, woman, and child belonging to or serving the earth at this time, whether he or she is in or out of embodiment. And that's true regardless of how asleep someone might be or how unaware he or she might be on a conscious level or how their behavior pattern maybe doesn't reflect the conscious awareness of what is occurring at this moment. We've each been preparing for a very long time. And the legions of light in the heavenly realms have consistently said, the greatest privilege and honor of any evolving son or daughter of God in any level of evolution in this cosmic moment is physical embodiment on planet Earth. Because we are going through a unique experiment that has never been attempted in any system of worlds. Never has a planet that's fallen to this depth of separation and duality been given the opportunity to move forward this quickly into the light. And we've all heard the expression, God needs a body. So for us to succeed in this unique experiment, there have to be awakening souls in the physical plane willing to absorb the light of God from all of these cosmic influxes of light that we've been experiencing. It has to be drawn through our heart flames, the divinity within us, in order for it to manifest tangibly and physically in the physical plane. And we've all been preparing for this for, as I mentioned, hundreds of lifetimes. And there have been many, many of those lifetimes where we have literally gone through what we have called weeping and wailing through our valley of tears. And I could go up and down the roads here of these chairs and ask you to tell me the horrors that have happened in your life just in this embodiment. And you'd all have stories of incredible things we've been through. Well, we volunteered to go through those things, not because we're masochistic and we wanted to see how miserable we could be, but we volunteered to go through those experiences because we saw the bigger picture. And we know the universal law is, as I am lifted up, all life is lifted up with me. So when we were making those agreements from the higher realms of truth, we volunteered to come into the depths of the densest, darkest frequencies of pain and suffering on this planet, knowing full well that as we awaken and we raise up, we create this upward rush that lifts all life up with us. And the reason we agreed to go through these things is because we were shown this moment. And we knew that there would be a moment in time that was referred to as the shift of the ages, when we would have the opportunity to bring the light of God into the physical plane in a frequency of vibration that would literally lift this planet and all her life out of our long, long exile in darkness and return us to the spiral of evolution where we could catch up with the rest of our solar system and move forward in the light. Now, this cosmic moment that we're in the midst of What I want to share with you tonight is the information that's being given to us by our sisters and brothers in the heavenly realms. This consists of all of the magnificent avatars and the beings of light associated with the various world religions, with ascended masters, cosmic beings, all of the great elders and ancestors, the entire graded orders of all legions of angels, solar logos, beings of light from suns beyond suns, and galaxies beyond galaxies. The whole of creation is focusing on this planet because of this unique experiment that we are going through. And every single person is working to assist us. Because never has a planet this far fallen this far into the darkness and been given an opportunity to succeed in moving forward in the light during the shift of the ages. And when we succeed God victoriously, which we absolutely are going to do, we take our collective experience with us. And what that means for our sisters and brothers in the family of humanity throughout creation is that we are taking this full experience with us into the higher schools of knowledge. So our sisters and brothers throughout creation are going to be able to learn about the experiences of separation and duality without ever having to delve into the pain and suffering that we have experienced on this planet. And we are literally creating a new octave of Godhood that is expanding the borders of the kingdom of heaven throughout infinity. And let me tell you, they are elated that they don't have to go through what we've gone through in this experience. For this cosmic moment, they have literally created an amphitheater of light that encircles this planet and extends into the heavens as far as our eyes can see. They have projected their luminous presence into this amphitheater of light, and they are radiating their light to us for this cosmic moment. They have been granted permission from our omniscient, omnipotent, omnipresent Father, Mother, God, the cosmic I Am, all that is. They have been granted permission to amplify our efforts 1,000 times, 1,000-fold. That means for each and every one of us in our individual unique experiences that our efforts are being amplified as though there were 1,000,000 people doing the identical same thing. And when we come together in a group, that is exponentially expanded. And it's because of this opportunity is why the world religions and the prophecies of old said that in this time, the changes would be able to take place in the twinkling of an eye. Now, I'm going to share with you this information. I don't ever want you to accept anything just because somebody's told you it's so. I'd like you to take it into your heart, see how this resonates in your heart flame. Anything that doesn't resonate, just let it go. I promise you, if I'm sharing anything tonight that's important for you to understand, to fulfill your facet of the divine plan, and it doesn't resonate as truth at this moment, your I Am presence, your own divinity, is going to keep presenting that information to you in loving, gentle ways over and over again until you can finally let it in and it resonates as truth. But for this moment, they want us to understand why we have come together in this sacred conclave. And when I say this sacred conclave, we are here in this particular focus, but there are literally millions of awakened souls all over this planet that are aware of this cosmic moment, that are joining with us in consciousness.
For more information on the next Star Knowledge Conference, go to starknowledgeconference.com.